الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فهو المهتدي، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وبارك على عبدك ورسولك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him, we seek help from Him. We ask forgiveness from Him. We seek refuge in Him from our own evils and our own bad deeds. Anyone who has been guided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is indeed guided. And anyone who has been misguided, you will never find a guardian to guide him. I bear witness that there is no deity except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, without any partner. I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is His servant and His messenger. O Allah, let your prayer, your peace and blessing be upon your servant Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his family and all his companions. In continuation of the seers of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's ethics, today we are still with the ethics of the al-istighfar, seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we're still with the verses that encouraging people to continuously make an istighfar, regardless, never give up. Istighfar, seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, has benefits that cannot be put boundaries for it. Unlimited benefits for istighfar. In Surah النساء verse 110 بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ومن يعمل سوءا أو يظلم نفسه ثم يستغفر الله يجد الله غفورا رحيما. If you do bad and if you commit injustice to yourself and then you seek استغفار from Allah سبحانه وتعالى, you seek forgiveness from Allah سبحانه وتعالى, you're going to find, for sure, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most forgiving, the most merciful. This is like the maximum you can expect, or you need. That even if you do wrong, even if you do injustice to yourself, even if you are on the wrong side of the way, but you come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love you to come back. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will welcome you to come back. And regardless, as long as you still have your soul in you, as long as you have, you're still breathing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to come and to make istighfar, and wants you to come and to come back to the right path. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you. What else you need? Forgiveness is there for you when you come back, regardless, whatever sins you made, so you come back sincerely. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be there. So you will find mercy, you will find forgiveness, you will find welcoming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is like a happiness that you cannot imagine, because you are Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala creation. He created you and wants you to be in His sight. And He warned you from the devil's side. And when you realize that the devil's side is wrong, you're coming back to him, he's happy for you to come back. Well, look at this another verse here. Surah Al-Ma'idah, verse 98. أَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ شَدِيدُ الْعَقَابِ وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. So this is warning and also attracting you to come back. Warning you that if you keep insisting on doing the wrong thing, for sure, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to have the severe punishment. If you insist and continuously, and you don't care, the severe punishment is going to, you're going to have. But still, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ghafoorun raheem. So both here. If you continue in your wrongdoings, and you don't come back to repent, then you're going to be punished, for sure. And severe punishment. Not only regular punishment, look, shadeedul aqab, severe punishment. وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. But if you come back to repent and come to the Allah's way, come to Allah's guidance, you will find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiving you, you will find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala merciful for you, and all the good things awaiting you. And also in another verse, Surah Al-Ma'idah 101, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَسْأَلُوا عَنْ أَشْيَاءٍ إِنْ تُبْدَ لَكُمْ تَسُؤْكُمْ وَإِنْ تَسْأَلُوا عَنْهَا حِينَ يُنَزَّلُ الْقُرْآنُ تُبْدَ لَكُمْ عَفَى اللَّهُ عَنْهَا وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ حَلِيمٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want to make it easy for you. Don't make it difficult for yourself. You know, the Islam is a religion of easiness. It's easy. There's nothing complicated, nothing difficult, no torture in Islam. You will find what if you are in whatever situation you are in, you can, for instance, take the salah, the prayer. You can pray at any condition. You can pray standing, regular prayer. If you are not feeling good, you could pray when you are sitting. Even you can stay while you're laying down. Even you can pray while you are walking. Some of the companions prayed while they were walking in a mission. You can pray while you are riding, in an airplane or a car or anywhere. Easy. If you can't find water in the location, you could make tayammum. So there's no excuse. Anything that you don't make it difficult for you. Just look for the easy way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had available for you and take it. And also, لا تسألوا عن أشياء إن تبدى لكم تسؤكم. Look, I will give you an example, for instance. The Bani Israel, the Jews, made it difficult for themselves. When they were, you know who killed this someone, and they asked the Prophet Musa to ask Allah who killed that person. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Prophet Musa to ask him to slaughter a cow. Okay, if the Jews at the time, the Bani Israel, just as soon as they heard that, they brought any cow from the street and slaughtered it, that's it. This was what they asked to do, and that's it. No, they didn't take it that way. They asked for details. And every time they ask for details, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make it more difficult for them. Ask for details, more difficult. Ask for it. So to the extent that the cow that was eventually they found it, that the owner of it asked for its weight in gold. See how difficult it was at the end. But in the beginning, if they just grab a cow from the street and slaughter it, that will do the thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask them to do. But they're asking for, they're making it difficult for themselves. Don't make it difficult for yourself. If you don't ask for things that is not related to your matter, don't, just whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you ease, just take it and don't investigate about whatever comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is good for you. So don't make it difficult. So take it easy because the religion of Islam is the religion of peace, religion of easiness. There's no complication, no torturing, no difficulty there. Everything is easy for you as long as your intention and you're doing things without the intention of violating the rules of Islam. So, تَسْأَلُوا عَنْهَا حِينَ يُنَزَّلُ الْقُرْآنُ تُبْدَى لَكُمْ عَفَى اللَّهُ عَنْهَا وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ حَلِيمٌ. Even if you do something and you don't have the intention to do it wrong, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, غَفُورٌ حَلِيمٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be the most forgiven, the most patient with him. Also, in another surah, another verse, which is Surah Al-An'am, verse 54, وَإِذَا جَاءَكَ الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِآيَاتِنَا فَقُلْ سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ كَتَبَ رَبُّكُمْ عَلَى نَفْسِهِ الرَّحْمَةِ إِنَّهُ مَنْ عَمَلَ مِنْكُمْ سُوءًا بِجَهَالَةٍ ثُمَّ تَابَ مِنْ بَعْدِهِ وَأَصْلَحَ فَإِنَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. So when you Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most merciful. This is he Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala written on himself, mercifulness. He's the most merciful. And if you do something wrong without knowing, without insisting, without persisting that you do it wrong, then you come to repent because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love you to repent. When you repent, and after that, إِنَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most merciful, the most forgiving. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to forgive and going to have blessing as long as you don't challenge, you don't violate in purpose. For keep that in mind and you will find your life in peace and your you're doing what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking you to do without any violation of Islam. In the expedition of Hunayn, this is when the believers, because there was large numbers, and they thought because they are large in numbers, they are not going to be defeated. They thought that the victory is from themselves or from being them more than the enemies. But this large numbers did not do anything in the victory, because the victory is coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They thought that the victory come from their numbers. They are more than the enemies. It did not work. With their victory, even in the beginning, the expedition of Badr, they were just 300 and the enemies was more than 1,000. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made them victorious, not because of their numbers, but because of the support of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descended the angels to fight with the believers. لقد نصركم الله في مواطن كثيرة ويوم حنين إذ أعجبتكم كثرتكم فلم تغن عنكم شيئا وضاقت عليكم الأرض بما رحبت ثم وليتم مدبرين ثم أنزل الله سكينته على رسوله وعلى المؤمنين. In the beginning, يوم حنين, you were proud of your numbers, كثرتكم, أعجبتكم كثرتكم, you liked you being large in numbers. Did not work, did not, was not sufficient for you to be victorious. And after that, you run away. As soon as you had problems, you run away. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Prophet Muhammad within you, and the strong believer within you, and you were desperate after all this. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the calmness on the Prophet and the believers and the strong believers. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the angels again that the believer did not see. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the victory again to the believers after the companions stood with the Prophet and they realized that the victory is not from numbers, the victory is from support from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ثم يتوب الله على اللهم بعد ذلك على من يشاء والله غفور رحيم. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would repent on the people that whoever wish will want. Some people that had a strong belief and they did not do that on purpose. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the door of forgiveness open. And whenever you come, you are welcome. There is no secretaries there, no permissions needed, no application needed. It's directly from you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You ask forgiveness directly from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You ask guidance directly from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No, nobody in between. This is the beauty about it, about Islam, that you do not need to go to ask somebody permit to be repented, like in some other religion. No. You and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala direct contact. You see how you should be proud of your slaveness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are the slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The slaveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is honor for you. You and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala directly. You and the owner of our soul. You are with the creator of us directly. Nobody in between, no permit to need it. Right away, you get connected. No materials between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Direct contact, anytime, day and night, regardless where you are, regardless how sinful you are, regardless how bad you are, regardless how whatever you are, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will welcome you. But as long as you come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ask forgiveness, you are always welcome. Now, when it comes to the people that who did not follow the Prophet in the expeditions, of course, some of them didn't want to follow because of being the weather was hot or they were lazy. So they did not follow the Prophet in the expeditions. And they waited until the Prophet comes back to ask for forgiveness again. And then Allah Subhanahu wa Taala told the Prophet about this, about the reality of these people. So when وجاء المعذرون من الأعراب ليؤذن لهم وقعد الذين كذبوا كذب الله ورسوله سيصيب الذين كفروا منهم عذاب أليم ليس على الضعفاء ولا على المرضى ولا على الذين لا يجدون ما ينفقون حرج إذ نصحوا لله ورسوله ما على المحسنين من سبيل والله غفور رحيم. So people who did not follow the Prophet because of they didn't have financial means to go, they don't have any means to ride or any means to take with them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that, and Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, even when they ask him, they say we didn't have anything to carry you with. Then they leave crying. These people that are faithful and they are sincere and they want to go with the Prophet, but they couldn't because they didn't have the means to do that. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows about them. But some people, they have no excuse. They have like examples of the three people that who did not follow the Prophet, and when they came back, they said the truth. They said that we don't have any excuse to follow you. We have all the means that we can go with you, but we will go after time until it not up that it not go. When they come back, because they said the truth, so Prophet Muhammad he knew that he said the truth, but asked him to wait until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take decision about them. And eventually, after days of patience, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive them because they repented. So this is the example of how when you are sincere to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, eventually Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you. Eventually Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be forgiven, will be merciful for you. So ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us and to be merciful to us all the time. Ameen. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. أدعو الله عسى أن تكون هذه ساعة إجابة. Supplicate, may Allah accept our supplication at this time. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. الله سبحانه وتعالى is the one who is going to relieve any calamities on you. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the owner of the hearts. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the owner of the hearts, that if you are in a situation that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide people to be in your way, to help you. So seek forgiveness, seek and istighfar is the gateway to get all this and more. Just keep on making istighfar all the time. If you just see this is something in your tongue to say astaghfirullah alazim alladhi la ilaha illa huwa al-hayy al-qayyum wa atubu ilayh, this is something that you will not realize how much benefits you're going to get out of this, because it's not only that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive your sins, no, that's going Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remove all calamities, and you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase your rizq. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make all your life in ease. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not punish you. There's also, you will have blessings in your family. You will have, because when you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you are surrounded by angels. And you are not only praying for yourself, the angels will pray for you. Also, when you recite the Quran al-Kareem at night, when you wake up at night, you do rakatin and recite the Quran al-Kareem loudly. Make sure you recite loudly, because behind you, around you will be angels and good jinn. That you like to listen, you like to hear the Quran from you. You will pray for you. Because the angels cannot read Quran, but they listen to the Quran. So when you do that, then you get the rewards of the supplications of the angels and the good jinns. وَيَمْسَسْكَ اللَّهُ بَضُرٌّ فَلَا كَاشِفَ لَهُ إِلَّا هُوَ وإن يريدك بخير فلا راد لفضله يصيب به من يشاء من عباده وهو الغفور الرحيم. If anything wrong happened to you, only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who is going to remove that calamity away from you. Nobody else. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will dedicate whatever will be a reason for this calamity to be removed away from you. And if something good going to happen to you, nobody going to block it. Keep that in mind. Whatever going to happen to you is going to happen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is it was his will for thing to do, to be, and it will be. So nobody going to challenge Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for things to happen for you. Because whatever going to and you may experience that in your life. Even if anything destined to happen to you, you know it's going to happen regardless. Regardless of anything in any situation. It's going to whatever written to be happening is going to happen. So and by this way you just go directly to the owner, to the creator, of this universe, and he's going to be in your sight. وما أبرئ نفسي إن النفس لأمارة بالسوء إلا ما رحم ربي إن ربي غفور رحيم. So when you in a situation just relate all bad things to yourself and relate everything to good to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and ask for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness and ask for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for mercifulness that you're going to find it there. So and this comes from istighfar and come from repeating istighfar all the time. وَيَسْتَعْجِلُونَكَ بِالسَّيِّئَةِ قَبْلَ الْحَسَنَةِ وَقَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ الْمَثَلَاتُ إِنَّ رَبَّكَ لَذُو مَغْفِرَةٍ لِلنَّاسِ عَلَى ظُلْمِهِمْ وَإِنَّ رَبَّكَ لَشَدِيدُ الْعِقَابِ. So some in the previous nations used to challenge Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they don't care. They think that the previous messengers, he was challenged, oh, go ahead, do whatever you want us. And when it was too late, when the punishment happened, is not that's what happened. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destined the damage to them, was any means, was wind, was the rot, the strong sound, the brain. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has soldiers. The soldiers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come from anywhere. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have the soldiers to happen and will destroy within seconds whatever challenging, whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destined to destroy. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us and to keep us away from any of such calamities. نبّع عبادي أني أنا الغفور الرحيم وأن عذابي هو العذاب الأليم. Look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the forgiveness and the mercifulness first. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell my slaves that I am the forgiven, I am the merciful first. And still, don't just take it for granted. My punishment is the severe punishment. The punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is severe, not only here in this life and in afterlife. So don't take it for granted. No, don't take advantage of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's patience on us. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most patient. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will deal with his slaves as they do, there's nobody going to be left on earth. Everybody will be punished according to the do wrong things, going to be punished and going to be destructed, going to be destroyed. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is leaving us all the time until the day of resurrection, and then the judgment is going to start. So be ready for that. Be ready for this punishment, for this judgment that accumulate as much good deeds you have and stay away from the wrong deeds and accumulate as much istighfar you have, because istighfar going to remove the bad deeds. Whenever you make istighfar and also when you make istighfar, look for, this is all in the internet you could find, when you eat, a certain way to start eating with istighfar. When you go out from your house, you start a certain supplication to do it. When you go to the bathroom, when you go to inside the masjid, when you go inside your house from outside, every Islam is a way of life. everything you do in this life, Islam is interfere in it to make you clean and holy and close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So find it, find this istighfar and do your best to repeat it. And this small surah that you remember, Ayatul Kursi, Al-Fatiha, or Ma'awazatain, or the last verses of Ayat, Surah Al-Baqarah, and all this, repeat them all the time. You find your tongue all the time remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَغَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. If you count the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on you, they are unlimited. Unlimited. You cannot, if you just count. If you look at the stories of people, they are someone who cannot move, he's paralyzed, he's has his sickness in every part of his body, but only his tongue is moving. And somebody passes by and he's still thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all the blessings. How come you ask for you thank Allah for blessing and everything is wrong with you? Just because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala left his tongue to thank him, that's by itself, it's a blessing that will no equal to it. So sit and write down the blessings on you from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comparing to other people, for instance. Just your health, just your sight, or for you to able to walk, or for you to do things normal. Some people, they can't do it. And see whatever, how much money you will pay if you get this blessing, for instance, if you didn't have it. Some people are very rich, but they will pay everything they own if they can get, for instance, their health back, or they get their sight back, or they get their ability to walk, just to walk back, or ability to smell, or the ability to see the colors. Some people, they see everything black and white. And you can see that when people were able to reach the point to do that, how happy they are. So count all this blessing, and when you count this blessing, thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all this. Even the rak'atain al-duha, in the morning, this is sadaqah, charity for all what you, for all the bones in your body, for all your body, to make sadaqah on yourself by praying tarqatin al-duha, because that will equal for all this blessing that you have, pay back by do such prayers, do such istighfar, do such supplication. So this topic is very long, inshallah, we'll continue on in the future khutbah. So أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم. Oh Allah, help us to purify ourselves in body, mind, heart, and spirit. Oh Allah, do not let our heart deviate from the truth now that we have been guided, but grant us mercy from your very presence, for you are the grantor of bounties without measure. My Lord, help me to perfect my prayer and of my descendants. Our Lord, accept this prayer. My Lord, forgive me and my parents and all believers until the day of resurrection. Glory to Allah, Lord of majesty and honor. And peace be upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his family and all his companions. Praise to Allah, Lord of all creations. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي للصلاة حي للصلاة. Come to salat, come to salat. الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله. إلا الله.
استغفر الله وأقم الله. الله أكبر
الله أكبر.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
آمين.
الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
صلى الله عليه وسلم.
ربنا لك الحمد.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله
أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
آمين.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح ورأيت الناس يدخلون في دين الله أفواجا وسبح بحمد ربك واستغفر إنه كان توابا. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده.
ربنا لك الحمد.
الله أكبر.
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 Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Astaghfirullah.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. This book here about Islam, the illustrated guide to understanding Islam, is very comprehensive, and also what's good about it, it has the electronic version of it, website for all the entire book. So I would encourage you at least to take one. This is free, and also the posters also for verses are free. Encourage you to take at least one or as many as you want, if you want to pass to any of your non-Muslim brothers. And at least take this link and have it in your social media and pass it. Because you don't, this is, as soon as you click on this, you will access all the content of this book online. So please do that. This is a form of da'wah, so you can share. Because this is Islam, is we need to tell non-Muslims about the beauty of Islam. So this is a way. Please take some of them, and especially that you get that link and share it in your social media. Please. And also the posters. The posters and the books are free.
Brother, may I make a statement? Well, the statement I can make is that how beautiful and eloquent that it was when you mentioned how you can go to Allah direct, but Allah, He don't want nobody to come to Him under the state of you know, intoxication, anything like that. You know, when you're not proper.
You know, brother, Allah Subhanahu wa Taala, He's our Creator. He knows us. He knows everything about us. So even if you are sinful, but you feel that you want to go, come back to Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. Go to Him. Don't say that, oh, I'm drunk, I cannot go to Allah, I cannot repent. No. This is not, don't give this excuse. Go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seek help. Like this young man, when he went to the Prophet, I said, oh, Prophet Allah, make permission for me to make zina. And all the companions was very upset and were about to hit him and do the bad things to him. So Prophet Muhammad dealt with him in a very professional way. And he went to permission to make dhikr, to be excused for that. And the Prophet told him, Do you accept that on your mother? Say, no, I don't want that to happen to my mother. Do you accept that to your sister? No. Do you accept that to your daughter, to your wife? No. I said, people don't like that to happen to them as much as you don't like to happen to you.
But the reason why I mentioned that is because it says that when you don't pray, don't make salat under condition of intoxication. That's why I mentioned
that. Of course, when you should follow the rules. But when it comes to repentance, don't say I am sinful so I cannot go to Allah. No.
Okay.
Don't let any wrongdoing prohibit you from going back to Allah and repent to Him.
May Tawbah.
Yeah, you repent any condition you are in, you go to Allah subhanahu directly.
Yeah.
But of course when you pray, you need to know that you need to make wudu, Hey brother, exactly, hey brother. You need to do to be, to do the right thing. When you make the fasting, you should not eat, you should not do whatever. Yeah, when it comes to ibadah, you follow. But when it comes to repentance, don't say,
I have a story for you.
Faster?
We are early, yeah.
Oh, sure. Okay.
Yeah, we start at 1:30 and finish on 2.
Yes, okay. Inshallah, we'll do the best.
Yeah, because...
I hope that everybody, we just wait on the student. Somebody comes in, we'll start right away. So if you please come early, for sure we'll start right away. But we're here from 1:30.
Right. If you announce it, yeah. If you announce it, come 1:30, so yeah.